is Mary, and in this video, I'm actually gonna talk about my tattoos, some of them. Before I get started, I am Mary. Mocha's over there, I think. Like, comment, subscribe, turn on your notifications so that you know whenever I post a new video. So let's get started. So I have 23 tattoos. Two of them, which are that one and this one, are cover-ups. February 15th, 2016, I started making more tattoos, doing more tattoos. Like I said, I have 23. Most of the time you can see some of them. If I'm wearing a tank top, you can see the one right here. You can see these and the other one right there. Behind this year here, you can see it. I do want more. I have two. I wish I had the money to get right now so I can get them done and then start thinking about other ones I want. I do want to get full sleeves on both of my arms. See, I can go like that and show you the ones on my shoulders. The ones I can't show are the ones on my back, the two on my upper thighs, the ones on my calf, and the one on my foot. I can talk about them. So for me, tattoos have a meaning on everything. This side right here, this one right here on my back, I had, my first one was Taz, which is this one right here. It's Taz with angel wings, halo, and a rose underneath him. I got that for my 21st birthday present to myself. I got it the Friday of my 21st birthday. I was supposed to go to Las Vegas for my 21st birthday, but I started a new job, so I had to stay in Washington. So I decided, since mom and dad's out of town, let me go get a tattoo. And of course, mom and dad came home early, so that threw a wrench in my kind of in my plans. My next tattoo was on this shoulder blade. It was Winnie the Pooh. It was supposed to be Winnie the Pooh holding a banner, but instead of a banner, I have Winnie the Pooh holding a, smelling a rose. I got that August of 2001. And then we go to like I said 2016 or 2017. It was 2017. my first tattoo after that. Which I think one of my other videos I will talk about something, but in this video I'm not. So 2016, I came out as a lesbian. I had my first female relationship, which lasted 3 years. In that 3 years, I got all the tattoos except for the Winnie the Pooh and Taz. I also got Mocha. There was lots of ups and downs. I'll probably never talk about that relationship because I do care about the person a lot to this day. I don't think I'll ever have a relationship again. But if it happens, it happens. If it don't, it don't. I'm fine. I'm happy being who I am, working on myself, loving myself, taking care of my dog, taking care of Mocha Dog. I keep myself busy. I crochet, I knit. I crochet mostly. Color, watch my fish, which one of my betas, Halloween, passed away. So I either need to get a new beta tank so I can have another beta, or not have a beta and just deal with the crested gecko whenever I do get it. And then if I'm good with taking care of my crested gecko, get a leopard gecko. And Mocha knows with getting one of those, we go to his favorite spot, PetSmart. Yeah, you like PetSmart, huh? You like PetSmart? You like PetSmart in the park? Yeah. You like PetSmart? Yeah. Yeah. Did you get to go to PetSmart today? Yeah. So, like I said, so I got a sidetrack with all that. I did get my nose pierced 2017. Yeah, they all started 2017. So, the first one I got, which I need to put lotion on my arm, on my tattoos, because I'm not good about putting lotion on every single day. Only on my hands, because they're really dry, and then I try to rub the extra on my arms. So, I got Hope with a heart. Because something bad happened. And it was that time. So I got Hope tattooed. And like I said, most of my tattoos have meanings. Most of them have meanings and some of them are just because I liked them. Like Taz, it was just because in my 20s and pretty much all my life, I loved Taz. I still do. I don't have as much of my collection as I used to. I don't think I really have nothing from my collection. But if I see something cool Taz, I might get it, but I might not. So Taz, Hope was tattooed Because in a relationship, you need hope, faith, love. So I got hope tattooed. Then the next, this one right here. Now it's two roses with a heart in the middle with blue and purple. Purple? So, like I said, the roses are a cover up about four days later. I got the roses, and no. So I was in Philadelphia. Okay. So I was in Philadelphia. The 15th, I got this. The 16th, I got the first tattoo. And it was mine and my girlfriend at the time's initials. Which, the reason I did do that is I thought we were going to get married, so I was like, well, I'm not going to talk about it, but my advice for anyone with tattoos or anyone in a relationship thinking about a tattoo with their significant other, make sure you guys are going to be together forever before you do anything. I do still extremely care for this person, so I don't mind them on me, even though now they're cover-ups. At the time, it was a hard thing, so I had to cover up the names and the initials to help me to try to heal. So, if you get something that will go together, and like your tattoos, you can't really design something for someone else. Make it a unique tattoo for you guys, because you don't want to do this and your life is messed up. But like I said, I do care about this person extremely a lot. One of the things, if we did get married, I wanted a vase with blue and purple sand, and we poured it in together. And the reason you do that is a united thing, or unity thing. And with the sand, you can't pick out every single piece of sand from another color. So that's another reason I do love the color now, but that's why I put the two colors together, because it is her color and my color, but together it makes one color. So that's what this one is. It started out with our initials, with the heart, and then it went to, I love my tattoo artist, because he did a wonderful job. Then it went to the roses with just the heart in the middle, because I do love love, no matter what kind of love it is. Then the next was hearts with our names above them. Two hearts together with an arrow going through it, and then the names tattooed above it. So like I said, that was her name and my name. The feather is the cover up for that. Feather, you have to be free, and you have to be yourself, but it's also really pretty. So, there's that. And then if you've ever seen these, it's actually Mocha's paw prints, and they go up like that on the back, and then Taz is in the middle. On this shoulder blade, it has, the way I picked that out, it's from Pinterest, and it's two polar bears together. A big one and a little one, and they're cuddling. And then free-handed, I think it's called, I love you to the moon and back, kiss in the clouds. On this shoulder, from here to almost to the middle of my back, is, we'll start with Winnie the Pooh. So I had Winnie the Pooh done in 2001. Then I went and got him brighter, redone, and had Tigger added to Winnie the Pooh. And then I went and got every single Winnie the Pooh character except for Christopher Robin, the main characters, done on my back. These aren't in the order that I have them done, but these are the orders that I can think of them. So pretty much from each shoulder blade to the middle, it's almost done and covered. I love them, like I said, I love all my tattoos. And then on this arm, love with affinity symbol. Because like I said, you love forever. And then a crown. Because she was my queen. And this is the princess crown. I was wearing a princess crown necklace. I do wear it every so often. And then the shoulder right here. That is my sweet yellow bird. He passed away in 2014. I had him from 2007 to 2014. And that was a difficult time in my life. The first time I was going to get it, I cried. And I wasn't ready to go get it. Then when I finally did go get it, I was glad I got it, because now I can look down at him all the time and know he's there with me. I have him forever on my arm. And then on my right thigh, upper right thigh on the outside, I have Betty Boop and Tinkerbell kissing with pixie dust all around them. And then on my left upper outer thigh, I have four roses, and in the middle it has a banner that says love lasts forever, which is true. Your love for someone will last forever, no matter if they are in your life or not. They have a piece of you. Everyone that you are with will have a piece of you, and you will have a piece of them. So these two were done in Philadelphia. These two, and the name and the hearts, were done at the same place. The rest of them, except for one, was done by the same tattoo artist. The one on my upper calf was done in Destin, and it is two dolphins jumping out of the water at either sunrise or sunset, depending on what way you look at it. Which I think it's more like a sunset, because they're pinks and blues, and it's pretty. And on my left calf, it says, Ohana means family, and it's Lilo and Stitch hugging. On the outside of my ankle, above my ankle, I have Faith with a dragonfly. I think that's my dragonfly. Yeah, that's my dragonfly tattoo. And then on my inner, above my ankle, it has a butterfly, and it says, never let your fear decide your fate. A lot of people need to learn that and live by that and have life like that. On my right foot, on top of it, I have a butterfly, but instead of a butterfly, it's a skull with butterfly wings. And then this year, I have a tulip tattooed. I do want to get a tattoo gun and have it done, a heart right here tattoo, and I want to get a ring tattoo. I also want to get a umbrella tattoo on this side with raindrops, because you do have to go through storms to make everything all right. On top of my left foot, I do want to get a tattoo, but I don't know what I want yet. I want to get a lot of tattoos. I love tattoos. I love the color. I do like black and white. All mine, except for a couple, are color. So when you get a tattoo, think about where you want it done. And think about your pain tolerance. This piercing, most people get it done, and they have one tear rolling down their eyes after they get it done. I actually laughed, and the gentleman that did the nose ring, he was like, I have the Q-tip ready to wipe your tear, because I thought it was going to hurt. I was watching a lot of videos before deciding to get it done. I like it. I wish I could find a nose ring that... I love the studs. I wish I could find studs that will actually stay in instead of falling out. never finding them again. Luckily, when I know it falls out when I'm sleeping, I'll wake up and I'll find it and put it right back in after I clean it. But if you get a tattoo, think about what you want. Think about the meaning of it. You want a couple's tattoo, get something that you both like and no one else can have it. Because one of the ones that I wanted to get with my ex was a key and lock that says always and the other person has forever. Now, since I know I'm not going to be ever with anyone, I don't want to get that one anymore. I wish I knew how to draw so I could design more tattoos and try to do one on myself, or even though my tattoo artist would have killed me. But on that note, excuse me, that's a little bit about my tattoos and kind of what they are. I'm not going to give the names that were on here or the initials. I hope you like this video. Like, comment, subscribe, turn on your notifications to let you know whenever I post a new video. Comment below. Do you have a tattoo? Are you thinking about getting tattoos? And when you see this, I might be moved somewhere else or still in the process of moving because, like I said, I want to have all my videos for March already recorded and posted. So have a wonderful night or day, whenever you.